Hello, lovely humans. I am making a video about gesture drawing. Gesture drawing is defined as a quick drawing that shows the action, pose, and form of a figure. We also have some tips for gesture drawing if you wanted to pause the video and read through these quick tips. When gesture drawing, I normally start with the head. That's a pretty good place to start. And from there, I'll draw a neck and a spine, but I'll represent that by using a line. From there, I'll show a line to represent the shoulders. And for every joint or area in the body that moves, I'll draw a circle. So for like the where your arm attaches to your shoulder, I'll draw a circle for that. For people's torsos, I'll usually represent that by an hourglass sort of figure, and whereas not everyone is an hourglass figure, it just is something that I find is helpful to pinpoint where the waist goes on the person. Representing the pelvis with something as simple as a rectangle helps, and then where your legs attach to your pelvis, I represent with a circle. The knee was represented with a circle. The ankle, I even draw a circle there sometimes. And the foot can be as simple as just drawing a triangle. Each segment of your arm, where the bicep is and where the forearm is represented with a line. The elbow is represented by a circle, and the hand, I don't know, every time I do a hand it's different, so just try your best to make a gesture for the hand too. This part's just basically refining and trying to figure out, okay, so we got the stick figure down, we got the bare bones and the one might say a skeleton for the person. How can we make this person have a little bit more dimension to them? How can we make them have a bit more form? How can we make this person look a little bit more like a person? Being able to level up your stick figure and adding muscles basically to the skeleton frame is really helpful because then it will help you to visualize what this person would look like with more detail to them. Being able to gesture draw is a good, not only warm-up technique, but it will allow you to see what your person will look like before you commit to something large and before you have to add lots of detail to it. So it will be a good idea to kind of use these to just not only warm up and kind of get yourself ready for drawing a bigger picture, but it will also help you be able to figure out what your person will look like before you add clothing and extra detail and hair and things of that nature.